हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम संपदा कुलकर्णी वेलकम्स यू इन माय चैनल टेक टॉक्स। इन दिस वीडियो सीरीज आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग यू द कंसेप्ट ऑफ ट्री डेटा स्ट्रक्चर। इन दिस करंट वीडियो सेशन आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग यू द सॉल्व्ड एग्जांपल्स ऑफ इन ऑर्डर बाइनरी ट्री ट्रैवर्सल। इन द प्रीवियस सेशन इटसेल्फ आई हैव ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन द इंट्रोडक्शन टू इन ऑर्डर बाइनरी ट्री ट्रैवर्सल। फॉर योर रेफरेंस I am providing you a shortcut link in this write-up corner, because before going to solve the examples, you must know the concept of in-order binary tree traversal. Before moving to the content, I would like to request you to subscribe my channel Tech Talks and keep the bell ringing. Now let's start with the tree traversals. In my previous videos, already I have explained all the concepts in detail. They are depth first traversal technique and breadth first traversal techniques. Already I have given an introduction to all these things. If you are not aware about all these concepts, I am providing you a shortcut link for the same in write up corner. In this video, I am covering the concept of binary tree traversals, where I am focusing on in order tree traversal, where we are following a sequence of left root node and right. Here I am explaining you the same thing, that is what this LNR stands for. L it stands for left, N it stands for root, and R it stands for right. So this order we are going to follow in order traversal. In order traversal, this in is the name provided as per the position of the root node or in the sequence where we are processing the root node. So here we are going to process the root node after left and before right, that is in between to left and right. That's why the name is given, which is in order traversal. How to perform this traversal? I have again already explained this concept in detail in introduction wala video. You can go through that. In short, I am explaining you before we'll start for the traversal. Start with the root node and let's check whether the root is having left child or not. If it is having, step down to left and make it as root, and again check whether the root, current root, is having its left child or not. If it is there, we will perform this loop continuously till the root, every current root, is having its left child. If it is not, then check for a right child, make it as root again, and again let's check whether this root is having a left child or not. So continuously we supposed to follow the sequence, that is for first of all left, then root node, and then the right. So now let's start with the example. For that the steps are left, root, right. So this is the simple example we'll start with. Here I am providing you the in order traversal or the output of the in order traversal in this bottom area. So for this tree, let's start with the in order traversal. Let's start with the root node. For a root node, first step is to check whether the root is having a left child or not. If it is having a left child, step down to left. Here you can see that here in this example, or I am showing this figure for your reference to check whether every time whether a current root node is having a left child or right child according to our sequence or not. So let's check. For A, is it having a left child? Yes, it is having a left child. So what is our first step is, if the left child is present, step down to left. So that's why I am stepping down to the left and making this B as a root node. So now let's make this B as a root node, and again let's check for the left child of B. Here you can see that B is a leaf node, so that's why no any left child is present, and then after left we need to process the root node, the current root node. So which one is the current root node? B is a current root node, so we need to process it. So I have processed it. Processing it means I am displaying it in the in order traversal, or I am outputting it as the order of our tree. So B is displayed. Now after B, a root node, we need to check for a right child of a current root node. Current root node is B. Let's check for a right child of B. It is not present, so that's why we have done with the node B. It's left we have done, root node processing is done, as well as the right child it is also done. We need to go backward to root node A, make A as a root node. Now after A, making A as a root node again, you can see here we have done with the left subtree, and now it's time to process the root node. So now processing of the root node, and after that our next step is to check for a right child, whether it is having a right child or not. Here you can see that A is having a right child, so that's why I step down to the right child. Now make this C as a root node. After making C as a root node, now let's check again C is having a left child or not. Here in this figure you can see that C is again not having a left child, as C is a leaf node. So no left child is present, process the root node, and after that let's check for a right child. No right child is present, and here you can see that we have done with the in order traversal of the given binary tree, which is B A C. Now let's move to the next example, example number 2, with the steps left, root and right. So here the example I have already given, and let's start with the in order traversal from the root node. So now 10 is a root node. After root node, for every root node we need to check for a left child, whether 10 is having a left child. Here you can see that 10 is having a left child, so step down to 20 and make 20 as a root node. Again after making 20 as a root node, let's check for a left child, whether left child is present. Here you can see that no any left child is present for the root node 20. So after that, after left, we need to process the root node. So we need to process the 20 here in order traversal, and then go forward for the checking of a right child. Here you can see that the right child is present, so here I have already stepped down to 30 as a right child. Now make 30 as a root node, and let's check again for a 30 as a left child or not, is available or not. Yes, it is available. Step down to 50 and make it as a root. After making 50 as a root, our first step is to check whether 50 is having left child. No, 50 is not having left child, then process 50. Let's check for 50 as a right child. Is it having right child? No, 50 is not having right child. So where we need to go? We need to go back to 30. Here you can see that we have returned back to 30 and make this 30 as a root node and process it, because for 30 as a root node we have done with the left subtree, and now it's turned for a root node. So now let's process 30 and then check for a right child. Right child is present. Now make 60 as a root node. 60 as a root node, let's check whether 60 is having left child. No left child is present. Process 60 as a root node. No right child is present, so that's why we need to return back. So after returning back, make 10 as a root node. Again, now why we are making 10 as a root node? Because for 30 as a root node we have done with left processing of the root node, right? As well as for 20 we have already done with left, 20 as a root node, processing of a root node and its right subtree. Now it's turn to make 10 as a root node, so that's why I am making 10 as a root node. And let's check for the right subtree, because for 10 processing is remaining, but for 10 you can see that we have done with the left subtree of 10. Now it's turn to process the root node, so I have processed it, and now let's check for a right subtree. 10 is having a right subtree, so step down to 40 as a right child. Make 40 as a root node. Let's check for a left child. No left child is present, because 40 is a leaf node. Process it. Let's check for a right child. Again, no right child is present. And here you can see that we have done with the in order traversal of the given binary tree. So I hope you are able to understand how to traverse the tree with this second solved example. Now let's move forward for third solved example with the steps left, root and right. Here I have given you the complete binary tree as an example, and let's solve it to traverse the given tree into in order traversal. You can pause this video, you can wait till you are solving it by your own if you are confident about the steps which we supposed to follow while traversing the tree in order. If at the end when you are done with the in order traversal, you can resume this video to check whether you are correct or you are getting the correct results or not. Till then, we will finish with the in order traversal. Let's start with the root node 11. Let's check for a left child. It is present. Step down. Let's check for a right child again for 22 as a root node. It is present. Step down to 44. Let's check for a left child of 44. No, it's not present. So now let's process the root node, which is 44. Let's check for a right child. No, it is also not present. Now here we need to go back to 22 as a root node and process it. After that, let's check for right child of 22. It is present and step down. Making 55 as a root node, let's check for its left child. No left child is present. Process it. No right child is present. Now, where we need to return back? Here you can see that for this subtree where 22 is a root node. So this whole subtree we have done with left root node and right. Now it's done to go back to 11. After going back to 11, you can observe here that for 11 we have done with the left subtree and now it's turn to process the root node. So here I have processed the root node and now let's move forward to the right subtree if it is present. Here you can see that the right subtree is present, so that's why move down to the right child, that is 33. For 33, again make it as a root node and let's start with the left child again if it is present. So for 33, you can see here the left child is present, so that's why move down to the left child. Make 66 as a current root node and let's check for a left child. It is not present. Process a root node 66. Let's check for a right child. It is also not present. So here we need to return back to 33 to make it as a root node again. Here again you can see that for 33 we have done with the left child. Now it's time to process it and I have processed it in order traversal, displayed it in order traversal, and now let's check whether 33 is having a right child or not. Here you can see that 33 is having a right child, so that's why move down to the right child, make it as root node, and left child is not present, process it, right child is also not present. Here you can see that we have done with all the nodes as far as all the nodes are present in this original tree, and the in order traversal is, you can see that 44, 22, 55, 11, 66, 33 and 77. So in this way our in order traversal is done for the given example. Now let's move forward for the example 4 with the steps left, root and right. So this example is somehow skewed binary tree at the right direction, and in order traversal will traverse the tree starting from the root node. No any left tree or left child is present, so process the root node and move forward for a right child if it is present. Yes, it is present, so step down to the right child 33 and make this as a root node. For 33, let's check the left child. It is present, so that's why step down to left child, which is 66. After stepping down to 66, make it as root node and let's check for a left child again for 66. No any left child is present, so that's why process the root node 66 and check for a right child. Here you can see that no any right child is present and we need to return back to 33 to make it as a root node. And here I have returned back to 33 and I have processed the root node and now it's turn to go for a right child if it is present. It is present, so that's why step down to right child 77. After 77, making it as a root, we need to check for a left child. No any left child is present, so that's why process 77 and let's check for a right child. Yes, right child is present, so that's why I step down to the right child. Now 22 is a root node and after that let's check for a left child of 22. Here you can see that the left child of 22, it is present, which is 44, so that's why I step down to 44, make it as a root and let's check again for a left child. No left child is present, so that's why process the root node 44. No right child is present, return back to 22. After returning back to 22, process the root node, current root node, which is 22, and let's check for a red child. Yes, red child is present. Make 55 as a root node and let's check for a left child. No left child is present. Process 55. No red child is present. And here you can see that we have done with the in order traversal for the example number 4. And the in order traversal is 11, 66, 33, then 77, then 44, 22 and 55. In this way, we have done with the in order traversal of the given binary tree. Now, the next example will give you the, or the last example of this video session will give you the, again or remind you the steps of left, root and right of in order traversal. Here, I have given you the example. Again, if you are confident about the in order traversal of the given binary tree, you can pause this video, you can traverse the tree and you can check your answer, tally your answer with my answer at the end of this example. So now I assume that all of you are able to solve the example. Those who are not able to solve the examples, you can continue with the video. So now let's start with the in order traversal with root node A. Let's check for a left child. Yes, it is present. Step down to the left child. Now make B as a root node and let's check for a left child. Here you can see that whether B is having left child. Yes, B is having left child and its left child is D. So that's why I step down to the left child D and make it as a root node. After that, now let's move down to the left child if it is present. So yes, G is a left child which is present. So that's why step down to the G and make it as a root. Now after making G as a root, again let's check for a left child. No, left child is not present. And now after left child, the next step is to process the node. So that's why processing of the root node is done over here. And then let's check for a right child of G. No, any right child is present. Now after that, where it will return back? You just think about where it will return back. So it will return back to the node D. And D will become a root node again. So after becoming D as a root node, process it and let's check whether D is having a right child or not. D is not having right child, so that's why we need to return back to the previous level again. Now where it will go return back? It will go to the node B. Now let's process the B first of all by making B as a root node, and now let's check again for B as a, if the right child is present or not. Yes, the right child is present. Step down to the right child and make it as a root node. After making E as a root node, now first of all let's check for a left child of E. It is not present, so that's why process E as a root node. And now let's check for a right child of E. It is also not present. And here we have done with the right subtree of a root node B. After that we need to return back. So where it will return back? It will not return back to B, because we have already done with the B as a root node. B as a root node, its left subtree is also done. The processing of root node is also done and the right subtree is also done. So where it will return back? It will return back to A. And after returning back to A, it will process it as a root node, because for A as a root node, we have done with its left subtree. So we have done with its left subtree. So that's why we have processed the root node A. And now it's turn to check for a right child of A. It is present, so that's why step down to its right child C. Make it as root. Let's check for a left child. No left child is present. Process the root node C and let's check for a right child. Yes, right child is present, so that's why step down to the right child, which is F. Make it as root. Let's check for a left child. Yes, it is present, so that's why step down to the left child H. Now H will be a root node, and after that let's check for a left child. No left child is present, that's why process the root node H. Check for a right child. No right child is present, so that's why return back to the previous level. Where it will return back? It will return back to F because we have stepped down from the F to the left child. So we'll return back to F and process it. After that, for F, let's check for a right child. Yes, right child is present, so that's why step down to I as a right child. Make it as root. Let's check for the left child, not present. Process the root node I, check for a right child. It is also not present, and here we have done with the in order traversal of the given binary tree. So the in order traversal of the given binary tree is G, D, B, E, A, C. Here we will move to F, but left child is present, so that's why we'll first of all revisit H, then F, and at the last I. So in this way, this is the in order traversal of the given binary tree. I hope you are understanding the concept of in order binary tree and you are now able to solve different examples also by your own. So thank you friends for listening and watching my video. If you like the content and the video, please like my video, please give the comment, and do not forget to share these videos with your friends. If you have not subscribed yet, here I am providing you the subscription link. Please do subscribe my channel Tech Talks. Along with this, I am providing you the shortcut link for the next video of this video series. Is nothing but the recursive algorithm for in order traversal, along with the playlist of this whole tree data structure video series. Thank you and stay tuned with Tech Talks. Thank you.